sports. It's in the game. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and the very mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. It's the first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports. And we will not have a run back here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 20-yard line. The first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 11 yards there on the first play from scrimmage. Well, there you go. This offense off to a strong start this afternoon.
Yeah, with a big run and a first down. That's putting what you practice into play. That's excellent execution to get things started.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now Dak, he wants to change the play.
27.
Prescott from the gun. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Cowboy first down. The Cowboys at 0-2 here to begin the season. And listen, they made their share of mistakes in these first two games, CD, but you know, talking with them in the days leading up to this one, doesn't seem like they've lost any confidence.
I would agree with that, and what they told us was that they weren't planning on making any drastic changes. They didn't see the need to shake things up. They were going to continue to plow ahead. They thought they had the right guys on the team and in the locker room. But they do have to start winning some games.
Vaughn on first and 10. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Now a second and 10. They just get the playoff. Now Prescott. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 41-yard line. A gain of 18 and a new set of downs.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
A first down carry by Elliott. Oh, and that one well designed as he'll take this down to the 30-yard line. 11 more on that one and another first down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
And he'll go down at the 28.
They'll go with a four-receiver look here. Two on each side as they face a second down and eight.
Now they'll change things up.
Gun. Kill.
Prescott.
Left side to Lamb.
Call it a gain of three on the play, and it brings up third and five now.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive.
Go, get out there. Under.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down.
Here we go, 47.
Throwing, Prescott. A dump off to Elliott. And he is going to lose yardage here. This will wind up a loss on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down.
That's a nice clip and save sequence there defensively, because they did everything as they would have wanted to. They forced a third down, blanketed the field with coverage, nowhere to go with the football, forced a dump off to the back. And even then, they closed quickly and got him down behind the line of scrimmage. You name it, they did it well in that last sequence.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Prescott to throw it. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Cowboys here unable to convert on fourth down. And this defense delivers a turnover on downs on the very first drive of the afternoon. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 26.
Hey, Ozzie, shut up.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
He was looking for Rashad Bateman there.
And it's second down.
You look at this Cowboy defense.
They've been pretty good against the pass. Not amazing, but good. Number 13 in the league.
And since this is such a good unit of covering passes downfield, I think that last play is typical of what we might see. A lot of short passes. See if they can generate some run after the catch. But nothing doing on that one.
Here's second and 10.
Now it's Jackson.
That's complete. It's Rashad Bateman.
9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris.
And he's going to have a Ravens first down as he'll get this up to about the 42.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guy can take it the distance. But a short yardage, trying to pick up first downs, that big guy, always a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
First down, and they go back to Harris.
And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47.
It's a pickup of 11 and a Baltimore first down. Couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive.
Cut.
Jackson now. And it's out. He put it on the carpet. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And now off to the races down the right side. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys. And he has great speed, defensive back speed. Once he got it and took off, there was no catching him.
And I know every team tells you to... or what the play, but there was no chance of catching him.
And now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. No score after one on EA Sports. Raven football here as we begin quarter number two, as they've got it with a first and 10. Jackson. Bateman's got it on the crossing route here. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
What a drive this has been. Just chewing up the yardage. And here's one of their best plays yet as they finally get down into the red zone and look to finish this off with six.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Play action. It's Jackson. There's Flowers. He's got it. Touchdown, Ravens. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Well executed there offensively. Defense looked a little confused, but he found his receiver, and that one good for 6 points.
And the payoff we just saw there tells us how many times they ran this play in practice over the past few weeks, because they executed that flawlessly right here on game day when the situation arose.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
The Cowboys take over first down. That's it.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They've got some stuff to build on from that last drive, because they moved the football, CD, and then they tried to go for it on fourth down, didn't convert, probably left a bitter taste in their mouths.
I would say so, and I think that they go out in this series determined for that not to happen again. In fact, they don't even want to get to a fourth down opportunity. They just want to make sure they get it done within the parameters that they've set for themselves. Run their offense, get it into the end zone. Yeah, I think a little bit of determination and a dash of anger.
Yeah, here we go.
Inside give to Elliott. And he can muster only a couple here to the 24.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great, great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
Now Prescott. Looking left side, it's complete, he's got it. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route, and they just executed that one pretty well.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now Dak, he's going to mix it up. A handoff left, Elliott. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. So that time they got the left guard with a hold.
And let's face it, in today's ball, you might have that 330-pound guy you're supposed to clear out of there. You might need a little bit of extra help by grabbing the jersey and trying to ride him out.
Prescott now. This ball taken in here by Brooks. It'll be a gain of just a yard, and that will bring up second down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Back quite a ways here, facing second and 19. Here's Prescott. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And that'll force upon him a third and 14. They need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. Kyle Van Noy in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down.
Even keeping the back in for extra protection on third down, they still couldn't prevent the sack. Now it's fourth and long thanks to a terrific individual effort on defense.
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. Deonte Hardy back deep. So just a 3-yard return following a punt of 45. And the Ravens, they'll take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. And look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
And he is out of bounds inside the 35. 40 yards rushing for him now on just his first 3 carries.
And that was a familiar carry there by Harris, who broke off a nice bit of yardage. And he's been a productive back throughout his young career, eclipsing the 1,000-yard mark in each of his 3 seasons as a pro.
Jackson eluding the pressure right, looking for Bateman. He's got him complete, and he'll be taken down with a first down as they get about 14 out of that one, and we go to the 2-minute warning.
change it.
To throw is Jackson. He'll find Bateman once more. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it'll be second down. So a decent gain there, but not their fourth consecutive first down like they had on the first three plays.
You sound almost disappointed there. You want to fire the offensive coordinator on that one or what?
They've gotten into a rhythm. I thought they were just going to keep going.
Well, almost a win for the defense, but if that's your win, you're not doing very well right now.
Throwing is Jackson. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Kind of a fine line when you're setting up the screen. You don't want to throw it too early and have the defense react too quickly. And you definitely don't want to throw it too late, and that way it's not formed perfectly. Got to make sure you hit it just right.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Harris running straight ahead. And the ball is knocked out. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. All fumbles are costly, but that one really hurts because he had the first down.
Yeah, that's all he needed, right? But the problem is we coach these guys to try and get more, but that doesn't count if you don't bring the ball with you, does it?
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They'll take over deep in their own end after the fumble recovery as they start 1st and 10. And he gets it to the 30 when it's all said and done. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. Once he broke through that first wave of defenders, there was a pretty big gap there for him to run.
And it helps that they were in a dime defense. That's 6 defensive backs. So this is why a lot of teams now are searching for those linebacker safety combo type guys who can add a little bit more size on the defensive side of the ball but can still run as well, because when you run against 6 DBs with some bigger offensive linemen, you often get this result.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Play action now, Prescott. He's got a man, it's his fullback. And he gets this up to the 34, out of bounds there.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. He's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put there.
Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there. You might out of a smaller back.
Here we go, going to 54. Hey, count. 47. 47.
To throw is Prescott. And Cooks has it over the middle. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a 1st down.
I think that's a big pickup for a 1st down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a 1st down. Executed it to perfection. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Yeah. Up the middle, here's Elliott. In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith. The Cowboys going to use their 2nd timeout now, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the 1st half. Second down and 6 now.
Here we go, 46. 46.
Looking to throw, Prescott. Pass complete to Jalen Tolbert. And he's going to be taken down with the 1st down at the Ravens' 34-yard line. The Cowboys signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this 1st half.
Here we go! Right there! What do you think?
Now Prescott. No, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose. And this ball recovered by the offense. But remember, they cannot advance it here in the final 2 minutes of the half. So this will be blown dead, and it'll come back to the spot of the fumble. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. On play action, Prescott. Come back route into the hands of Tolbert. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A good looking drive for the Cowboys so far. It's a first down. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. And that hits off the left upright, and it caroms away, no good. And this will stay at a seven-point game.
Well, I'd say that it's fair to say nothing has gone right in this first half for them. Even here, you've got a chance to at least get on the board, but that goes by the wayside. And now this coaching staff, they've got to figure out some way to wake this team up at halftime to get them going.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And they'll have time for one play. That's it. 3 seconds to go before intermission. And they're just going to run it here up the middle. And he's going to lose yardage. Not that it matters as the final seconds tick away. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three.
Brendan Aubrey to kick off for the Cowboys.
The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Their defense has pitched the shutout. Now they probably need to deliver a little breathing room, maybe make it a two-score game as they've got it first and 10. Now Jackson. That is caught, Rashad Bateman. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20.
As they began this drive, I was wondering how they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Another first down, this time on a gain of 19. So they go pass, now they go run, and two plays resulting in really nice pickups.
Certainly sounds like a 50-50 deal, doesn't it? Sounds like great balance. Well, you know what all those coaches have told us over the years, Brandon, that balance is? It means doing what you want to when you want to. That play calling is working very well for them right now.
Down to the 25. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
From the 25, here's a second and 9. Play action. Now Jackson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Flowers. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. They go play action with Jackson. They'll roll him out right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Micah Parsons showing off that elite athleticism as he gets the sack. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Here's Jackson. And this is going to be incomplete. That one doesn't find its target, but all in all, he's been much sharper this week. He was under 50% a week ago, and now he's up over 70%.
Well, you know it's standard for quarterbacks and receivers to get together for a little extra time each and every day in practice. I get the sense they got together for a lot of extra time this week to try and improve that passing percentage, and it's worked out quite well.
And now they'll fake the give here on the end around and look to throw. Walker with a grab, left side. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. It'll be a loss of two on the play, and it'll be fourth down. So Jackson will head to the Ravens sideline, and on comes Justin Tucker for the field goal try. A 33-yarder from the left hash. And Tucker, the former Longhorn, puts this one through, and that will extend their lead even further. Well, they picked up right where they left off in the first half. First drive after the break, they come away with three and increase that lead.
Yeah, and you just want to keep building on that lead, don't you? Whether it's 6 points or 3 points, take everything you can get. Keep maneuvering, keep adding to it, keep making it difficult for them to come back.
And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
Here's Prescott. A short one there taken in by Ferguson. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
And it's a real luxury when you have a guy who can turn a short throw into a solid gain at any moment. Once he caught that ball, he ID'd where the open grass was and got there in a hurry to pick up a new set of downs for his offense.
Prescott now from the 50. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down.
But looked like the defense, they were ready for that one.
Really left him almost no room to work after catching the ball. He could throw every move in the book at him. They were there, and they tackle him for a loss.
Able to hit his target, Lamb. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Prescott and Lamb hooking up for the Cowboy first.
And that's the kind of play this offense needs to maybe kick them into gear a little bit. They've been stuck in neutral much of the game. Perhaps that can give them a little bit of confidence that big plays are out there.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10.
Kill.
Throwing. Prescott. He's got it complete to Tolbert. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. Crossing route complete. Catch made by Cooks. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Every now and then I can speak from experience because I do know as a defender, it is awfully hard to stay with your man on these crossing routes because even if you don't get picked, there's a danger of being picked either by one of their receivers or maybe by your own defender. And on that play, that worked quite well.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Elliott going to get it again on second down. And he'll be taken down after a minimal pickup, and that will take us to the end of quarter number 3. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Here comes play number 9 now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Prescott now. He'll get this to Elliott. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down.
And a penalty accepted, and they move the ball forward.
Here's another 1st and goal, but from a little further back this time following the penalty. Yeah. And they'll turn to the power game to try to get in. And he gets halfway there down to the 1-yard line. Only 1 yard that time, 2nd and goal.
That's someone who's pretty happy right there. That's the defense coordinator. Body after body getting to him before he can get started.
One man in the backfield, that's Elliott on 2nd and goal. Touchdown! CeeDee Lamb from 1 yard out. And the Cowboys have made it a 1-score game again here in the 4th. Had the option there, read it perfectly, and an easy little touchdown toss.
And it has to be a sharp throw, too, because of where they are on the field, the extra traffic, things are condensed near the goal line. Good route by the receiver as well.
Now the extra point up and good by Aubrey. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this 4th quarter. So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. Up to midfield. Justice Hill. He might take this all the way. He will take this all the way. Touchdown, Ravens. A big-time special teams play here in the 4th quarter to extend their lead.
And coaches preach it all the time. If you can score on special teams,
your chances of winning the game really jump up in a big way. Now, I'll let our analytics friends quantify it and give us the exact numbers, but that's what coaches talk about all the time, that extra momentum, that extra bounce you get from a special team score.
I don't have any analytics friends. Those are your friends.
I'll claim them.
So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff.
And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a two-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly.
They're going to 54. Wide in.
Prescott. And that's complete to Cooks. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. And that's good for a gain of 6, and it's second down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. From the 33, here's a second and 4.
Gun. Here we go, 46.
Draw play, Elliott. And Zeke will have a Cowboys first down as he gets this up past the 40.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
They keep on the ground with Elliott, and he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. And that's a loss of 7 on the first down play.
These guys off the edge are already tough to contain when they're protecting a stationary target. Ask them to hold their blocks when a runner is struggling to find a lane, often an impossible task. Regardless of the outcome on the scoreboard, that will be one of this game's biggest stops.
Now, after the loss, he'll have to navigate a 2nd and 17.
Here we go. Hey, kill!
Now Prescott. That to the sideline, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And the Ravens are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield.
And that pretty much has been the storyline, Charles. This defense, they seem to be one step ahead from the start of the game until now.
And you identified it perfectly, and we can see the frustration that's settling in now. And it's probably been there for a long time. But now it's evident because you can see it in their faces, you can see it in their body language, maybe even a little bit in that play call that ended up maybe closing them out.
After the interception, here's Jackson. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time.
13. Sit up.
First carry now for Justice Hill. And he's got this pretty close to a first down at the Cowboys 44. That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Hill. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Second and 10.
Hey, middle, middle, middle.
This is Walker. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Now it's Jackson. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 24-yard line. And they'll get 14 yards out of it and a fresh set of downs. On the give, this is Harris. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys, they're just saying, let's just keep running it out, and we've got them now.
Another run on second down, trying to cover up. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks. Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs and mini camps for these situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and secure a victory.
To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. They hand this off to Harris, and he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So here comes Justin Tucker in a big spot from the right hash here. Should be an easy one. And Tucker, the former Longhorn, puts this one through, and that will open the lead up now to 20-7. So they settle for just the 3, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the 4th.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but they still ate up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. This is first and 10.
All right, two.
Prescott. That's caught by Tolbert. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Open man, the tight end, Luke Schoonmaker. Big strides, look at him go. And finally wrestled down at the 8-yard line. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. Now first and goal. Here's Dak. For the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. We saw a lot of that a week ago defensively from him. AFC Defensive Player of the Week just always seems to be around the football.
I like your observation there. Understands the game, understands positioning, can put himself in the right spot, and then make a play on the football.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Here's Prescott. And it's intercepted at the goal line. It's C.J. Henderson picking it off.
Well, I mean, field goals probably aren't going to cut it at this point. This was touchdown or bust, and unfortunately for them, it turned out to be bust.
Yeah, they're feeling like they've got to force the issue here, maybe take some chances they wouldn't have earlier in the game. But give credit to this defense. They've really stood tall throughout, and they come up with the interception in the end zone.
We've got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. And he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and seven. He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball. And he has the Ravens first down, and it would appear that that's going to be the one to do it. They go down to a knee and a sigh of relief as they are into the win column for the first time this year. So the final seconds tick away in this Baltimore victory. And it was their defense that really paved the way to this victory as they allowed the one touchdown, and that was all she wrote.
Almost want to do the defense chant right now, right? Defense with a couple of claps in there, but no one wants to hear that from me. Let's just talk about how they got it done, though. When you take care of every aspect of the game, shut down the run, control the airways, right? Make sure the quarterback is harassed. This type of performance you get. They can't fashion together any offense, no consistency, and they just took control.
So for Baltimore, they're into the win column now as they move to 1-2.